Alright guys, so I did a lot of prep work here, so you could see all this. It took a long time actually, but I'm kind of glad I did that now because it is not going to be a long video. So here, what is the perimeter of the square above in inches? Okay, so here this square, right, we're given just square root of 2, but we're also given that it's a square. Now, if you remember your special right triangle formulas, right, we know that this right here, it's a square, so half of it, so this is 90, right? So half of it's 45. So this is a 45-45-90 triangle, which the formula is x square root of 2. So x square root of 2, right, it's right here across the 90, and then x equals 1, and then x equals 1. So here we're given this x square root of 2, right? So we know that x equals 1. So if we plug it in here, we're given that x equals 1. So then our perimeter is just 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 equals 4. So then final answer here is C, 4. All right. Now the next one. I know it's a bit complicated, but we'll see if you could break it down. So we have 9 playing cards from the same deck are placed as shown in the figure above to form a large rectangle of area 180 square inches. What is the perimeter in inches of this large rectangle? So if you hear, these are the long way, right? And this is the short way, width. Okay, now we gotta recall a few things. So here the total area is length times width. The perimeter here, right? The perimeter is everything, right? On the outside. So everything added. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 W's. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 L's, right? And then we have the area given, 180 square inches. I just kind of didn't write the square inches just to save time and clean whiteboard space. So then here, 180, right? So 5W, so my length here, 5W times width. Width is just this plus this. So then since it's being multiplied, I could divide the 5 out and just kind of simplify a little bit. 180 divided by 5 is 36. And then you're left over with W times L, W times W. It's just W squared, so LW here. So my LW is playing over here. So just my regular playing card has an area of 20. And here's how we figure it out, because 180 divided by 9 gives us 20. So this little area here is just 20. So then that's how we got our LW. So then I plug it in, right? Plug it in, boom, 20. Subtract 20 to both sides, get 16. W squared equals 16. Square root both sides, W equals 4. So we're not done yet. We move over here. We have 5W is equal to 4L. 5W is equal to 4L, so this is the same length. Now we just plug it in, W equals 4. This 4 cancel out. L is equal to 5. Remember our perimeter, right? So where we bring down the formula. 7W plus 6L. And plug it in. 7 times 4 is 28. 6 times 5 is 30. 30 plus 28 is 58. So P equals 58 inches, right? That is our answer. Okay, so here, the next one, we have two shapes. So we have a rectangle and a triangle. So the figure above has length as marked in units. What is the area in square units of the figure? So we want to find out the whole area, right? The whole area. So we have 10, 10, 16, and 2. So the rectangle is easy, right? So it's just area equals length times width. Right, so my length is 16, Emma with this too. I kind of wrote them backwards, but you get the idea. So it's 32. 2 times 16 is 32. Now, we don't know what this height is, so we had to figure out by using the Pythagorean theorem, and it's not given. So we go here, we go a squared plus b squared equals c squared. A squared plus b squared equals c squared. So 8 times 8 is 64, 10 times 10 is 100. 64 minus 64 is 0. 100 minus 64 is 36. So we drop down b squared equals 36. We square root both sides. B equals 6. Now that gives us our height. So area of a triangle is base times height divided by 2. Base is 16. My height is 6. 16 times 6 divided by 2 is 48. So my area of the rectangle plus my area of the triangle is 32 plus 48, which equals 80. And that is my final answer, D, 80. That is the area at 80 square inches, or units squared. All right, moving on. So here we have a rectangle. Has an area of 72. We're trying to find for x. So again, area is length times width. My length is this, my width is this. So I just plug it in, right? X plus 3 times x minus 3. Now we FOIL it out. X times x, x squared. X times negative 3, negative 3x. 3 times x, positive 3x. 3 times negative 3, negative 9. So these two cancel out. X squared minus 9, right? Add 9 on both sides. 81, x squared equals 81, square root both sides, x equals 9. Final answer is D9 is x. All right. What is the width of a rectangle with an area of 48x squared and a length of 24x? So again, A equals L times W. So my area is the same. We plug it in, plug in the L, and we just solve for W. Luckily, it's 48 divided by 24, which is just 2x. X squared divided by x is just an x. 2x is my answer. Final answer, B. That is how you do that one. This one, it reads confusingly enough, right? But it's just letting you know that this is 90 degrees, right? So all these are 90 degrees, so that makes it a square. So given by the definition, it's a square. And all these lines, right, this line, there's 12 of them, if you count, right? It all adds up to 24. So what you have to do here is get 24 divided by 12, which gives you 2 units of length per line. So each one of these lines is equal to 2 units, right? So we get this, and then we just kind of draw it over here, right? We move it over here. So then we have 2, 2, 2, 2. 2 times 2, right? It's 4. Long story short, B is your final answer. All right. So let me know if you have any questions, comments, or concerns. I hope this helps you guys out. Again, I hope you got a great, 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 great day. Guys, always remember to keep it PG. Don't do anything rated R and come back alive.